Hey guys, my name's Austin. I'll be your river guide today. Today we're going to be paddling up the creek here. We're going to check out a beaver dam. We're going to get out to Vermilion Lake. What's your name?
Tyler.
Nice to meet you, Tyler.
Thank you.
Nice to meet you, Chris. Okay, let's have a good day out there.
Awesome, let's go.
I've been around for a long, long year. Stole many a man's soul of faith. I was around when...
So last time I was out here, guys, I saw the biggest beaver I've ever seen, but I mistook it for a small bear. I actually brought a picture to show you here.
Oh wow, that's massive.
Yeah, pretty cool. So look at the precise handiwork we have here of the dam. Listen for any water trickling out. And when we do get up here, we'll take a look at the high water on this side.
So why do they do this?
That's a great question. Let's go somewhere a little more quiet, we'll talk about it.
Okay, let's do it.
I've been around for a long, long year. Stole many a man's soul of faith. I was around when Jesus Christ.
Okay guys, so we just made it to some wetlands here. Just paddled from the dam. Tyler, you asked, why do the beavers make the dams? That's a great question. We will revisit that. But for now, how do you guys feel about beavers?
Honestly, they're pretty cute.
Yeah, super interesting as well. And the homes.
Yeah, definitely. I do agree with you, but not everyone sees them as cute. They are pests in a lot of places, and they actually cause millions of dollars of damage every year just in the U.S. alone. And I'll pass around a flyer here I have. It's actually an article about the destruction the beavers cause. Okay, so take a look at that. Beavers are the largest rodent in North America. They weigh in about 65 pounds. That's 30 kilograms. Or if you took 40 chihuahuas, combine them into one, that's how large a beaver full grown would be. Okay, they're very large. They're found in abundance around here, around North America in general. And saying that, the residents of the wetland habitat here largely depend on the beaver's hydro engineering for their survival.
So who are the residents of these wetlands we see around us?
Well, that's a great question. So maybe if we cup our ears, we can hear some. Yeah, we hear some yellow warblers, some red-winged blackbirds. We have an abundance of waterfowl, songbirds, shorebirds. We have osprey and hawks and eagles in the sky that fish in the waters because of their relatively shallow depths. If you look in the waters, you might see fish, you might see frogs, turtles. There's even little animals, little invertebrates, insects that feed on all sorts of organic material in the water there. It's one big happy family of biodiversity.
Speaking on the residents, why do they depend on the beavers for survival?
Yeah, well, beavers are a keystone species. So that means other animals in the ecosystem largely depend on the beaver for their survival. Wetlands can be thought of as biological supermarkets. So again, this material we see in the water is actually called detritus, and it's broken down plant material. It's formed into organic material. It's a food source for the invertebrates, for small fish, and in turn, those small fish become food for larger fish, for birds, and it's a whole cycle in the wetland habitat here. Without beavers making their dams, the water level wouldn't be this high, and it would be dry land here, and a lot of the residents would be packing their bags and fleeing the area. And if we all know the Banff housing market, that is no easy task.
So what makes the beavers hydro-engineered?
That's a great question as well. So they precisely engineer the dams and the lodges with wood, with stones, with rocks, with whatever they can find. They play a fun game of beaver Tetris. So this just actually floated past me right now. And this is a piece of an aspen tree here, and you can see the hard teeth of the beaver act as a woodworking chisel and chisel this down into a perfect piece that they'll pack in their dam, very strong. And you can have a look at that, and it packs very tight to form a water seal, so no water can get through. So beavers create wetlands here by damming their waterways, raising the water level, essentially to build their lodge on. And they want a depth of water where they feel safe to swim around in. But what that inadvertently creates here, guys, is a wetland habitat by flooding out what was dry land here, and other animals are attracted in and increases the biodiversity. Now, the flourishingly diverse neighborhoods here largely depend on that hydro engineering from the beaver for their own survival. But it's not only the wildlife that benefit from it. Humans do as well. 90% of waterborne pathogens are gone because of wetland habitat. The CO2 in the air is absorbed in the soil into organic carbon. So they regulate the greenhouse gases on Earth. They also regulate from flooding, having these wetlands here. So maybe the beavers are just trying to save the planet. So what's the best thing about being a beaver, guys?
Beaver tails?
Beaver tails? Correct. But also their wetland creation, increasing biodiversity in the area, of course, right? And what's the worst thing?
A lot of damn work.
It is a lot of damn work. Let's paddle along, guys.
I watch the glee while you kings and queens fought for 10 decades for the gods.